Greetings to all and welcome to the session 2 of unit 1 of subject machine tool technology for fourth semester diploma of mechanical engineering pertaining to the course code 15ME43T. Myself Muhammad Imran, lecturer in the department of mechanical engineering, government polytechnic, Harvard. So in the today's session we are studying the following content: chip formation, orthogonal and oblique cutting. So we'll cover the chip formations, orthogonal and oblique cuttings. So the chip formation. So in the last class we have studied the basic of a metal removal process. The metal removal means it is the process of removing the unwanted metal from the workpiece in order to give the required shape and size. So as I told you, the metal from the workpiece is removed in the form of chips. So mainly there are three kinds of chips formed. One is continuous chips, another one is discontinuous chips, and next is continuous chips with the built up edges. So in the today's session we are studying all this chip formation, the cutting condition and advantages and condition for getting the continuous chips. So the continuous chips are formed when machining a more ductile material like copper, aluminium and mild steel. So the continuous chips will be formed while machining a ductile material. So what is ductility, you must know? Ductility means the ability of the material that can be drawn into thin wire. So like copper and aluminium, so that the copper is used in making the wires, aluminium also you can see the wire. So that kind of materials when they are machined in the machine tools, these continuous chips are formed. But this is not the only condition for getting the continuous chips. The next point will include the longer and continuous chips are formed in continuous chips, it is the most desired form of chips. So in all these three kinds of chips, these continuous chips are desirable form of chips. Means in order to get the good surface finish and all those good dimensional accuracy, the continuous chips are expected from the workpiece while machining. So the good surface finish, in continuous chip the good surface finish is formed and the tool life is less. This is one of the disadvantages. So why we'll get the less tool life, we'll study next discussion. So the condition, cutting condition for continuous chips are it may be ductile material. So for getting the continuous chips we should have ductile material, and the thickness of the chip will be small. That means depth of cut will be very less. You should give to give the less depth of cut for the ductile material. This then will be kind of likely to get the continuous chips. High cutting speed and the large rake angle, the lubrication. So cutting fluid. So if you use the cutting fluid during machining, it also leads to formation of cutting continuous chips. What is lubrication means? So it is used to remove the heat generation. So during the metal to tool contact, there will be heat will be generated. That heat will reduce the efficiency or efficiency of the tool or efficiency of the machine, and also generate the friction. So in order to remove these things, the cutting fluids are used. So if you use the cutting fluid also, we will get the continuous chips. So you can see the figure, the continuous chips. This is the tool. So this is the jobs. If you tool is cutting the workpiece, so these kind of chips are formed. You can see it is continuous, it is not breaking anywhere. So it will form like a curve shape continuously. It will form like this, and it will get down to the floor. So the chips will be continuous. For this kind of chips is also having some disadvantages. You can see here the next this one. The advantages of continuous chips is they generally produce good surface finish. Because the chips is continuous, the surface finish will be very good, and the most desirable because the forces are stable and operation becomes vibrationless. Because the continuous chips are formed, The forces acting on the tool and the workpiece is continuous. There will be no disturbance or stability in the forces acting on the workpiece from tool side. So stable, and the operation become vibrationless. If the chips is not continuous, sometime it will break, means that the forces will be differ and the vibration will happen. Again, if the chips will form, then the vibration will stop. So that will lead to the disturbance and sounds, noise will be formed. That will not be there in continuous chips. They provide high cutting speed. So the continuous chips will encourage for giving higher cutting speed. So this is the limitations we can see here. The continuous chips are difficult to handle and dispose of. This is the only one of the main disadvantages of the continuous chips. Since the chips are continuously coming curlier, and it will fall on the ground continuously without breaking. So that will affect the operator working is there, working on the machine. So it will damage his legs or damage his hands. So it has to be disposed of, which is continuously lot of disturbance in the ground floor nearby the machine tools. If immediately it is not disposed of, it will lead to disturbance. And also since the continuous chips are coming, though if you unexpectedly, if the operator touches the these chips which is very sharper and which is very hot, it will lead to damage of hand, it will make wound. So this is the main disadvantages of continuous chips. In order to avoid this, the chip breakers are used. So chip break, what will happen after some length of chip, it will break the chip. So in order to remove this disadvantages, the tools with chip breakers are used. That will break the chips. When certain length of chip is formed, it will automatically break the length, break the chips. Then it is very easy to dispose. And if it is not used, then every time after some time of machining, the operator has to stop the machine and has to remove that the chip form. Again, he has to continue the machining process. That will increase the production time of the component. So next is the continuous chips remain in contact with the tool face for a longer period, resulting in more frictional heat. As I told that the chips are continuously formed, there will be a continuous contact of chip and the tool. So that will lead to friction between the chip and the tool. So that leads to generation of heat. If the heat is continuously producing, then what will happen? That heat will be transferred to tool, the heat will be transferred to workpiece. So that may result in decreasing the efficiency of the workpiece. If the heat will be absorbed by the tool, it may changes its dimension. And also the workpiece also change. If you heat any component, what will happen? It will leads to dimensional changes that will affect the overall efficiency of the workpiece and also the overall efficiency of the machine tool. So immediately it has to be the heat has to be removed by using the cutting fluid. So this is the purpose of using the cutting fluids while machining the these continuous chips. So next is the continuous chips coil in a helix and curl around the tool and the work, and even may injure the operator. As I told, it may injure the operator because it is having a sharp edges. If sudden break loose, particularly a computer controlled machine tool, because they tend to get tangled around the tool, and the operation has to be stopped to clear away the chips. So in case of manual machine, the operator can stop the machine while the chips are continuous coming. After some time, he will stop the machine. He will break the chips and he has to remove the dispose of. That is that can be possible. But what happened if you use computer numeric control where the operator involvement is not required? What will happen? It is a closed chamber. We have to close the door of that cutting zone. So what will happen if the continuous chips is coming, it will flow onto the tool or workpiece or any other part, so it will damage us or it will stop the operation. So what will happen if any disturbance will come, it will stop the operation. Again, the operator has to come, has to dispose of, and has to run the programs again from the beginning. So that will increase the production times. So in order to avoid all those things, the chip breakers has to be used. But it is always not desirable in case of CNC machine. The continuous chips are not desirable because of these disadvantages. If it is continuously coming, it will flow onto the other parts of the machine, or it may be a form on the workpiece or any checks. So that will the sensor will sense that and will automatically stop the operation. Again, the production time will be increased. This is the only disadvantages of the continuous chip. So for this reason, the continuous chips in some operation is not desirable. Although it gives a good surface finish, it is not desirable because of these disadvantages. So next is the discontinuous chips. So you can see here, in case of continuous chip, the chips is continuous and it is a form of curl shape. You can see in the discontinuous chips, the chips will break like this here in the form of powder. The powder will be formed, the chips will continuously break, and in the form of powder it will get down or come into the machine, will fall onto the machine collector, the dust collector or maybe chip collector. So what is the characteristics of discontinuous chip? You can see form the when machining more brittle materials like cast iron, bronze and brass. What is brittle material? It will break without any deformation. So that may be glass or cast iron. So while machining the brittle material like cast iron, bronze and brass, this discontinuous chips are formed. Usually the casting material, you can see if you machine the cast part, the continuous powder will form. That is a discontinuous chips. Separate and small pieces of chips are formed separate. You can see this is separate. If you see in the microscope, that this discontinuous chips will be like this. You can see it is small pieces. It will fall onto the chip collector in the form of separate and powder, in the form of powder. So it is separate and a small piece of chips are formed. The tool life is good. Why the tool life is good? The tool life is not good in case of continuous chips. Why? Because the continuous chips, what will happen, there is a continuous friction contact between the tool and the workpiece, so there will be more friction will be generated, and that will lead to wear of tool, and also the tool life is less in case of discontinuous chip. Why? Because the tool life is good in discontinuous chip, because there is no much contact between the chip and the workpiece, because the chips, when the chips once formed, it will not will be in contact with the tool. It will fall down onto the chip collector. So there is a less contact between the tool and the chip surface. Thereby there is no friction will be generated between these two surfaces. That's why there is no heat will be generated. If there is no heat generation and also there is no friction, it will automatically increase the tool life. So next, the low power consumption. So power consumption for forming discontinuous chip is low, because there is no friction between the tool and apple. The power consumption, the torque is also less in this formation, because there is no much contact between the tool and workpiece. But in case of continuous chip, there will be continuous contact between the tool and the chips, that will lead to high torque. So that requires more power. Here the power will be less. So cutting condition for a discontinuous chip is, you need a brittle material first of all. For cutting condition, getting discontinuous, you need a this one, brittle material, large depth of cut. In case of continuous chip, the depth of cut is small, but here the depth of cut is large. The low cutting speed, cutting speed should be low. In case of continuous chip, the cutting speed is high, and the small rake angle. So this rake angle, everything will be studied in the next class. This is the geometry of the cutting tool. You can see here the rake angle means, so this is the rake angle. You can see this is back rake angle, the angle between this taper line and this striped surface. This is back rake angle, and from this side view you can see this line to this straight line. line drawn is from the edge to the this taper line of the side cutting edge. So this is the side right angle, this is the right angle. If this angle is small and if you increase or decrease the rake angle, that will affect the formation of these chips. You can see here, in case of continuous chip, the large rake angle is large. So in case of discontinuous chip, the rake angle is small. So these are the some advantages and disadvantages of discontinuous chips. The main advantages is, since the chips break up into the small segment, as I told, the friction between the tool and the chip reduces, and resulting in better surface finish and better less heat generations. Limitation, disadvantages of this discontinuous chips is, because of the discontinuous nature, the chip formation, the forces continuously vary. As I told, in case of continuous chip, since the chips is continuously formed, there will be a stable force. But in case of discontinuous chips, what will happen? The chip will form, then it will break. Between the breaking of first chip to the formation of next chip, there will be some time gap. That time gap, what will happen? That time, in that time gap, the force will vary. So that will lead to the vibration and the formation variation of the forces. That will lead to vibration and noises. More rigidity or stiffness of the cutting tool holder and work holding device is required due to varying cutting forces. Because of the varying cutting forces, the rigidity of the cutting tool holder and the work holding devices is required, and that means we have to tighten the cutting tool and also the workpiece in a very rigid condition, very stiffly you have to load the workpiece and also the tool. Consequently, if the stiffness is not enough, the machine tool may begin to vibrate. As I told, the cutting forces varies continuously. The machine tool, if the the tool and the workpiece is not secured firmly, it will vibrate and chatter. This is in turn adversely affect the surface finish and accuracy of the component. It may damage the cutting tool or cause excessive wear. So reasonable factor for getting discontinuous chip is machining brittle material, as I told, because they do not have capacity to undergo high shear strain involved in cutting. Very low and very high cutting speed. The cutting speed may be very low or very high. It should not be average. A material that contains hard inclusion and impurities have structures such as graphite flakes, gray cast irons. So if you machine these kind of materials like gray cast iron and graphite, this discontinuous chip will form. The depth of cut should be large. As I told, depth of cut should be large. Low rake angles. This is the geometry of the cutting tool. The rake angle should be small. Lack of an effective cutting fluid. If you don't use cutting fluid, then also cutting continuous chips are formed. Low stiffness of the tool holder or machine tool, thus allowing vibration and chatter to occur. Next, continuous chip with the built up edge. So these kind of chips are formed while machining ductile material also. This continuous chips with built up edge is formed while machining the ductile material. Why it is formed? Though it is a brittle material, why the continuous chip is built up edge is formed? Because in the cutting zone or cutting condition, if the temperature is high, if the temperature and the high and the extreme pressure in the cutting zone. So in the cutting zone, the temperature is very high and the extreme pressure in the cutting zone, then it will lead to the formation of built up edges. The high friction in the tool chip interface may cause work material adhere or weld to the edge of the tool. You can see here, this is the built up edge. You can see a small pieces of chips are adhere to this tool, this will lead to the formation of built up edges. So high friction in the tool chip interface, so friction between this tool and the workpiece is high because this is the continuous chip. What will happen during the continuous chip? The friction will be high, as I discussed in the earlier class. What will happen? The high friction in the tool chip interface because work material some part of the work material, see, small pieces will adhere to the or weld to the tool. So that will form lead to the formation of built up edges. The successive layer of the work material adhere to the built up edge, and when this edge become larger, the unstable, it break up. So what will happen? So the small part of this, because of the high temperature, the small part of this work material will adhere to this tool. You can see here. So it will, what will happen during continuous machining, it will successive level will added to these built up edges. What will happen? The continuous chip will break after some time automatically, so that the built up edges will be formed. So cutting condition for getting continuous chip is, it should be a ductile material, the cutting shoot should be low and small rake angle. You can see all those, this cutting condition is very similar to the continuous chip. Only the difference is that if the in the cutting zone, the temperature should be very high, and the temperature and pressure in the cutting zone should be high. Only during that period only this built up edges is formed. Why this temperature is high? Because due to continuous friction between the chip and the tool work surface. Because this chip is continuous, the friction between the tool and workface is continuous, that will lead to generation of temperature. And also if the pressure is high in that cutting zone, till a small part of this built up edges of workpiece will adhere to this tool, that will form the built up edges. So the advantages of this built up edges, you can see, although built up edge is generally undesirable, you can see the built up edge is undesirable, as it will decrease the surface finish and surface finish of the component is not undesirable. Is the stable built up edge is usually desirable because it reduces the wear by rotating the rake face of the tool. Okay. The discontinuous chip, continuous chip with built up edge is usually undesirable, but a small stable built up edge is desirable. Why? Because it will adhere, since the some part of the built up edge is adhere to the rake face, it will protect the rake face from wear and tear, so that will increase the tool life. Reasonable factor, as I told, low cutting speed, low rake angle, high feed, inadequate supply of coolant, high affinity. Next, the limitation, this chip is this is a chip to be avoided. So this kind of chip should be avoided immediately. If you find this built up edges, you need to take the immediate action. Why? Because it will damage the surface finish. This phenomena result in poor surface finish, high power consumption, the power consumption will be high, fluctuation in cutting forces induces vibration that causes tool failure. So reduction, so what are the what will happen if you get the built up edges? These are some factors that will reduce the formation of built up edges. You should have to increase, if you see that the built up edge is coming, then you have to increase the cutting speed, increase the rake angle, decrease the depth of cut using the an effective cutting tool, using the sharp tool, light cuts and higher speed, use a cutting tool that has lower chemical affinity. Okay. So next is orthogonal and oblique cutting. So what is orthogonal cutting? The cutting edge of the tool is perpendicular to the direction of tool travel. You can see here, this is the cutting tool and this is the cutting surface here. So this is the tool travel. So this is the tool travel. You can see the cutting edge of the tool. This is the cutting edge of the tool is perpendicular to the tool travel. So this is the direction of tool travel. You can see here, perpendicular between the edge of the cutting edge of the tool and the direction of the tool travel. So then it is called as orthogonal cutting. It is also known as two dimensional cutting, because you can see that exactly perpendicular, you can see only two dimension here. So the cutting edge of the tool is perpendicular to the direction of tool travel. The direction chip, the direction of chip flow is perpendicular to the cutting edge. So the chip formed here will flow perpendicular to the edge of this cutting tool. So chip So chip will form like this. So it should be perpendicular to the edge of this cutting. So the direction of chip flow is perpendicular to the cutting edge. It is perpendicular to the cutting edge. So it will form like this. So it should be perpendicular to the cutting edge. For the same feed and depth of cut, the forces which shears the metal acts on the smaller area so that the life of the tool is less. So for the same feed and depth of cut compared to oblique cutting, the forces which shears the metal acts on smaller area. So the forces acts on the smaller area of the tool. So you can see here it is a very small area here. So all the forces will be acting on the very small area of the tool, that leads to the decrease the tool life. In case of oblique cutting, what will happen? The same force, the same cutting speed will act on the larger surface of the cutting edge. It is a smaller face, but in case of oblique cutting, these same forces and cutting forces will act on the larger surface. If the surface is area is more, than the wear and tear is less. If the surface is less, if the same force is act on the small area, then the wear and tear is high. And if the same force act on the larger area, then the wear and tear is less. So in case of orthogonal cutting, the cutting force act on the smaller area, that will leads to less tool life compared to oblique cutting. Produces sharp corner. You can see here. You can see the last. It is a sharp corner. It will produce the sharp corner. You can see here, this is the. It will produce the sharp corner. Smaller length of cutting edge is in contact with the work. As I told, the smaller length of the cutting edge will be contact with it, the tool. Generally, parting of in lathe, broaching and slotting operation is done by this method. So, parting of operation in lathe, you can see, you have done already this parting operation in the machine shop. So, the parting of operation will be done by in the form of orthogonal cutting. And the broaching and sawing is also will be done in orthogonal kind of cutting. The next is the oblique cutting. It is also known as three-dimensional cutting. The cutting edge is inclined at an angle less than 90 degree. You can see in the oblique cutting, the two-dimensional cutting, the cutting edge is exactly perpendicular to the direction travel. But here, the cutting edge, you can see it is an angle less than 90 degree to the direction of tool travel. Let's say this is cutting edge. You can see this angle, it is 60 degree. So in case of this should be cutting edge, this will be like this, and that will be exactly 90 degree. But in case of oblique cutting, the cutting edge is at an angle less than 90 degree to the direction of tool travel. You can see here, this is 60 degree. This is the cutting edge. Line, if you draw a line from this cutting edge and you will draw a line from the direction of the cutting tool, you will get an angle less than 90 degree. So then it is called as oblique cutting. The chip flows on the tool face making an angle. So in case of orthogonal cutting, the chip flows is perpendicular to this cutting edge, but in case of oblique cutting, it flows at an angle. Since this edge is inclined, automatically the chip will flow at an angle to this cutting edge. The chip flows sideways in long wear. It will move like this, sideways in a long curve. The cutting force acts on the larger area. So you can see the larger area will be in contact. You can see this much area will be contact with within the tool surface. That's why the same cutting force, same feed will act on the larger area compared to orthogonal cutting. Since the larger forces will acting as same forces will be acting on the larger area, the cutting the life of the cutting tool will be higher in case of oblique cutting. Produces chamfer. You can see earlier the orthogonal cutting is producing a sharp corners, but here you can see here it is it will produce as a chamfer ends. You can see it is a chamfer end, angular surface will be produced. For the same depth of cut and the length of cutting, the cutting edge in contact with the work is higher. As I told you, the higher contact will be in case of oblique cutting for the same cutting speed and feed. This method is cutting in almost all the machining cutters, except that cut parting of operation and broaching and sawing. all the machines are performing oblique cutting only. So all kind of cutting is oblique cutting only. It is the most desirable form of cutting because it will increase the tool life. So next is the difference between the orthogonal and oblique cutting. See, the cutting edge of the tool is perpendicular to the cutting velocity factor, whereas in oblique cutting, the cutting edge is inclined at an angle less than the 90 degree as usual. The cutting edge clears the width of the workpiece. You can see here, it will clear, this is the width, it will clear every time the width of the workpiece in case of orthogonal cutting, whereas it is not the width here. This is not the width of the workpiece. So in case of orthogonal cutting, the cutting edge clears the width of the workpiece. The cutting edge may not clear the width of the workpiece in either end. In case of orthogonal cutting, the cutting edge will clear the width of the workpiece in both ends. Both end means what? This end and this end. You don't confuse what is the other end. This is one end, this is one end. If you do this one, automatically two ends will be formed. Here in both, you can see in the oblique cutting, in the both the ends, width of the workpiece is not cutted here. You can see here, it is angular. The chip flows over the tool face. Here also the chip flows over the tool face, but it is perpendicular to the edge of the tool. It is not perpendicular to the edge of the tool. Only two components of the cutting force are acting on the forces. Only three components of the cutting forces are acting on the tool. Tool is perfectly sharp. The tool is not perfectly sharp. Here in case of orthogonal cutting, the tool should be sharp because we are machining it for getting sharp edges. So here the oblique cutting, the tool should not be sharper. The tool contact chip on rake face only. The tool may generate surface parallel to the workpiece. Clearly shorter tool life, as I told, because of the same cutting force acting on the smaller area of the workpiece. Short tool life is short, whereas the same cutting force acting on the larger area of the tool, life of the tool is greater. Only one cutting edge in action, more than one cutting edges are in action. So this is usually used in single point cutting tool, and this is used in multi point cutting tools. So thank you. This will end up with this session. The next class will study further for this chapter. Thank you for watching.